There was a great famine all around the world. Everyone everywhere had nothing to eat and nothing to give their livestock to eat. They were starving, looking for food. But the people in the land of Egypt had nothing to fear. God had warned Joseph that the famine was coming. So for 7 years, Joseph helped Egypt prepare. They had stored up enough food for themselves and their livestock. They even had extra food. People from all around came to buy food for themselves. One day, Joseph's brothers came, and after some time, Joseph told him who he was. They were overjoyed that Joseph, their brother, was alive. They rushed home to tell their father, Jacob. Then they packed all their belongings, and they and their family set out to Egypt to live in their new home. Joseph and Pharaoh were eagerly waiting for them to arrive.
Pharaoh, my father and brothers are coming from the land of Canaan. They have come with all their flocks and herds and possessions, and they are now in the region of Goshen.
Joseph, do not worry. You're a good man, and I've been a faithful servant for the land of Egypt. We will welcome your family with open arms.
Thank you, great and mighty Pharaoh. I am so thankful for your hospitality. I know my family will be grateful as well.
Of course. If they're anything like you, the land of Egypt will become the greatest land of all.
Here they come. Pharaoh, these are my brothers.
What strong and mighty men, and so many. How many brothers do you have?
There are 12 of us in total.
I see. Welcome to the land of Egypt. What is your occupation?
We, your servants, are shepherds, just like our ancestors. We have come to live here in Egypt just for a while, for there is no pasture for our flocks in Canaan. The famine is so severe there.
Very well. Welcome to our home, and may this also become your home.
Thank you.
Now, Joseph, now that your father and brothers have joined you here, choose any place in the entire land of Egypt for them to live. Give them the best land of Egypt. Let them live in the region of Goshen. And if any of them have any special skills, put them in charge of my livestock as well.
Thank you, Pharaoh. You are too good to us, but we cannot take the best land.
Nonsense. Of course you can. Choose the land and have your family settle there. May the land become their land, and may they be blessed there.
Thank you, great Pharaoh. I also want you to meet my father, Jacob.
It is good to meet you, Jacob, and all your sons.
It is good to meet you as well. Thank you for the kindness you have shown my son, Joseph.
Well, he has proved to be more help to us than we were to him. He saved our great nation. The Lord gave us wisdom, and we have not been affected by the famine like the rest of the cities around us.
Yes, the Lord's blessing is on Joseph. Pharaoh, if I may, I'd like to bless you as well.
I would be honored.
So Jacob blessed the Pharaoh as they entered Egypt, the land that would soon be their home.
Now come inside our great palace and introduce yourselves. I want to get to know you and learn about what all you can do and how you can work here in Egypt.
And there was a new Pharaoh. And this new Pharaoh, he didn't like the Israelites. He didn't see our people as a blessing. He saw us as a threat. He thought that since we had gotten so big and we were getting so strong, that one day we would want to overpower the Egyptians and try to take their land.
Look at all these people everywhere. Look at these Israelites. Why are there so many of them?
Look at all those chickens.
I'm tired of them all.
Look at all those chickens.
If they go team up with my enemy, they will overpower me. I need to come up with a plan.
I know.
All of you will be my slaves.
He appointed brutal slave drivers over us, forcing us to work day and night, building their statues and pyramids. They worked us with no rest, no mercy. And we begged God, we cried out for God to save us, to deliver us. But we heard no answer in reply. Moses in it and put it in the river. She had tears in her eyes. We were all crying. We were praying that God would rescue Moses. We didn't know what was going to happen. But then the most incredible thing happened. The daughter of the Pharaoh, the daughter of the man who wanted to kill all these Israelite baby boys, she found my brother. And she felt sorry for him. And she took him and raised him as her own. God used the daughter of the man who wanted to kill him to rescue him. And time again, God would show Moses and us that he is a God who rescues. He is a God who provides, and he is a God who guides. That reminds me of another story. When Moses grew up, he became a shepherd, and one day, God spoke to him.
right now.
Wow, I remember that day so clearly. When the great I am, my God called me by name. He said, Moses, I have a job for you.
What?
I said, me, God? No way, I'm just a man like you. I was just a man, there's no way. I don't know how to communicate, speak properly. Said, Moses, trust me. I will send your brother Aaron with you. And so I trusted God and set off to talk to Pharaoh to let God's people go.
So Moses went on his way back to Egypt, and on the way Aaron met him, just like God said. And together they went to the Pharaoh to tell him what God had said.
Pharaoh, we have come to you from afar. My God, the God of the Israelites, speaks today. You must let his people go.
Is that so? I am their God. They serve me.
Pharaoh, if you don't listen, great plagues will come to your land. And you will know who our God is.
I will not let people go. These are my people. They're my slaves. They serve me. Call in the slave masters. Tell them, no more strife for their bread. They will pay for this. I will make them sweat.
So Pharaoh made the lives of the Israelites even harder. God had told Moses and Aaron to go to the Pharaoh to make the lives of the Israelites easier. But instead, things just got worse. Moses was so confused. He prayed to God, asking him what he should do, and God told him to go back and to tell the Pharaoh to let my people go. See, God had a plan in mind all along. God was planning the great escape. They just couldn't see it. They couldn't understand it. They just had to keep trusting God.
You're back again? What do you want this time?
Pharaoh, yes, I'm back, and I will keep coming back. My God says, let my people go.
Who are you to make the demands of the Pharaoh? These are my people. They serve me.
Pharaoh, God says, let my people go.
And not me.
The Pharaoh refused to listen. So God used Moses and Aaron to perform miracles in front of the Pharaoh. But the Pharaoh had his magicians perform similar things with their magic. So God told Aaron, take your staff and place it in the Nile River. And when he did, all the water in the river turned into blood. And then all the water in the entire land of Egypt turned into blood. Even the water they had stored in their houses, all of it, blood. Then he sent frogs to cover everything, the entire land filled with frogs. They were coming from every corner, every cupboard. There was nothing the Egyptians could do to get rid of them.
What is up with these frogs? They're everywhere. I can't stand these things. Why are they on my throne? Call back Moses and Aaron. Ask your God to take these frogs away.
I will ask my God, Pharaoh, but in return, will you let God's people go?
Yes, I will let them go. Just take care of the frogs.
So Moses prayed, and God lifted the plague of the frogs. But as soon as the plague was lifted and all the frogs was gone, the Pharaoh changed his mind and told Moses that he wouldn't let the people go.
Pharaoh, you broke your promise. You said you would let God's people go, but you lied.
Moses, you are a fool. I am their God. I already told you that. They serve me.
Moses, you must let God's people go.
I will not let them go. They serve me.
So God sent another plague. And again, the Pharaoh would grow tired of the plague. And he would call back Moses, and Moses would pray, and God would lift the plague. But then as soon as he did, again, the Pharaoh would change his mind. This happened again and again, plague after plague, until the final plague.
You're back again?
Yes, Moses. And I will keep coming back and back and back until you let God's people go.
I will not let those people go. They serve me. All of them, they serve me.
This is what the Lord God says. At midnight tonight, I will come throughout the whole land of Egypt. And every firstborn, Pharaoh, every firstborn, every firstborn of your livestock will be taken, and a great cry will come throughout the land of Egypt. Then Pharaoh, then you will know who our God is.
Enough! Leave my sight!
Pharaoh, you must let God's people go.
Take a lamb. with its blood mark the lintel and posts of every door. For tonight, I shall pass through the land of Egypt and smite all the firstborn. But when I see the blood upon your door, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not enter.
Son, my firstborn, my baby boy, the heir to my throne, he is gone. My son. My son. Call back Moses and Aaron.
Although we know
promised land. God guided us with a pillar of cloud during the day, and at night, a pillar of fire. We took our things, and we set off to the land God has promised us. Hallelujah!
No, no! I've made a huge mistake. Why did I let them go? We have to chase them. We have to go get them. Gather up armies. Get the chariots. We have to go after them.
was just one of the many miracles God showed us on our way to the Promised Land. Time and time again in Moses' life, God showed us who he was. See, Moses was just a baby that was supposed to be killed, but God rescued him. And then God used Moses to rescue the Israelites. And then when we were stuck between the Red Sea and the Egyptian army right behind us, God rescued us. He made a way even when it seemed impossible. In these next couple of days, you're gonna learn more about Moses and about his life. And I want you to pay close attention, because I know this is a story about Moses, but this story can also be your story. Maybe there's someone in your life who needs rescuing. Maybe it's you who need rescuing, and God's here to say, I am the rescuer. I have a way and I want to guide you. Maybe there's a moment in your life where you need to be brave and you think, I don't have the words to say, or I'm not good enough, or I'm not this enough. And God, just like he told Moses, is saying to you, I'm going to give you words to say. So pay close attention these next couple of days and allow God to speak in your life, because I know that God has amazing plans for all of you. So I hope that his story encourages your story, that you will know that God is a God who rescues, he's a God who guides, and he's a God who provides. Amen? Amen. Amen.